Nicknames are abound in today's heavily marketed, overly branded WWE world. Almost everyone has at least one, and in many cases, their epithet gets trotted out more than their actual name. When that Shield music hits, it's Here Comes the Big Dog, and Michael Cole will remind you that Braun Strowman isn't a man, but a monster among men at least a dozen times every single night. In fairness, some of these nicknames are pretty great, but the cynical WWE marketing machine has spat out boatloads of absolute stinkers over the past few years. None of these terrible monikers caught on, and despite WWE's best efforts, each provoked laughter, despair, or an unhealthy mix of both from the audience. I'm Andy from WhatCulture.com, and here are 10 wrestler nicknames the fans wouldn't accept. Number 10, Wildcat Kofi Kingston. This one came about following a post-match promo that Kofi cut back in 2012, during which he made reference to his Wildcat style between the ropes. Michael Cole leapt on this and promptly started driving it into the f***ing ground, because that's what he does. Some WWE fans have taken to calling Kofi Kingston the Wildcat, he said, when in fact this, like everything else, was just a product of the writing team. Naturally, the fans just didn't take to being told that they'd invented the company's latest dumb nickname, and it fell by the wayside soon after. Number 9, the Vigilante, Sting. According to Merriam-Webster, a vigilante is a member of a volunteer committee organized to suppress and punish crime summarily, or broadly, a self-appointed doer of justice. This is actually a pretty solid description of what Sting was in WWE. He debuted by screwing the evil authority at Survivor Series 2014, and while his run ended disappointingly, he battled Triple H and his corporate lackeys throughout the bulk of it. But the nickname was rubbish, and it fast became an object of ridicule online. Just call him the Stinger, or the man they called Sting. They're already established, Vince, you idiot. Number 8, the walking condominium, King Kong Bundy. Look, we get it, this fella was a big lad. 6'4", 458 pounds, built like Dr. Robotnik's Death Egg, the man was an absolute house. But the walking condominium? Really? First, there's the fact that Bundy was just a few letters away from being the walking condom, but could they not have picked a more imposing word? A condominium is what your da stays in on his annual saga holiday. That ain't scary. Besides, does a man whose name is already King Kong need a nickname? The answer, unsurprisingly, is no. Number 7, Mr. Ziggles, Dolph Ziggler. The show-off has always been a great nickname that captures Dolph Ziggler's character perfectly. He's a flashy guy who's out to steal the show. That's his goal, that's him, and that's his nickname. Mr. Ziggles, however, sounds like a particularly demanding kitten. This was a product of Dolph's 2009 feud with John Morrison, who tried to introduce it as a way of mocking Ziggler. It didn't get over, though, and if this is really the meanest thing that Big John could come up with, perhaps WWE were right to keep the microphone away from him for most of his run. Number 6, the kingpin of SmackDown Live, Dean Ambrose. The Lunatic Fringe is a crappy nickname for a performer who often resembles nothing more than a prop comic, but at least it caught on. Unsurprisingly, the kingpin of SmackDown Live did not. It's hard to figure out what Mauro Ranallo was going for when he started blurting this out in 2016. Were we supposed to believe that Ambrose was some kind of crime boss? A wacky 10-pin bowler, perhaps? Track 5 from side 3 of Wilco's 1996 studio album, Being There? Well, maybe not that one, but whatever the case, it didn't fit, it didn't work, and it didn't last. Shut up, Mauro. Number 5, the Great White, Sheamus. Dear Lord, was this one tone deaf. WWE were of course trying to compare Sheamus to a shark when they christened him the Great White, as well as referencing the big man's pale complexion, but the problematic connotations were all too obvious. No matter how offensive you think such a nickname is or isn't, if there's even the slightest chance of somebody taking it the wrong way, it probably shouldn't be used. Given that WWE temporarily sacrificed the awesome Celtic Warrior moniker for this, the Great White is even more egregious. Number 4, Big Hungry, Ryback. Sweet mother of Jesus, did Ryback have some terrible nicknames. The big guy was okay, but the human wrecking ball sounds like it was concocted by a 12-year-old, and as far as the master of the Feed Me More goes, Well, that doesn't even make sense. Regardless, Big Hungry takes the cake. Quite literally. Get it? Hungry? Cake? Ugh, just kill me. This was another one of those dumb names that Michael Cole tried his damnedest to get over, and in doing so, only succeeded in making himself sound and look like a complete and utter bellend. Number 3. Try for Triple H. When Paul Levesque was transitioning from Hunter Hearst Helmsley to Triple H in 1997, WWE were looking for a short, snappy nickname for the D-Generation X-Man, and that's where Try came from. It was bad, really bad. But if shortening his already curtailed ring name was such a priority, why not just call him H instead? Shoutouts to the guy from Steps. Jim Ross came up with this absolute stinker. Certainly not the legendary announcer's finest creation, but WWE were wise enough to can it when it failed to catch on, and soon, Try had bitten the dust. Number 2. Booger Red. Because nothing encapsulates a scary as hell 7-foot tall wrestling zombie quite like a big lump of bright red snot scooped straight from someone's navel cavity. Am I right, guys? Booger Red might be the dumbest thing that JR ever came out with. It was a horrendous, emasculating nickname for The Undertaker, and while it was supposed to allude to Tony Nobis, a former American football hard man, it sounded like an insult without knowing this context. And given that it was attached to a period of The Undertaker's career that is definitely best left in the past, it's probably a good thing that Booger Red died a quick death. Number 1. Silverback Mark Henry. This one fortunately never came to pass, because if it did, it would have caused an almighty storm. In 2007, Vince McMahon came up with an absolute brain fart, suggesting that WWE start referring to African-American superstar Mark Henry as a silverback. Now, a silverback is, of course, a type of gorilla. In fairness to Vince, he probably only had the creature's size and strength in mind when he suggested it, but the racial connotations slap you right in the face. Henry turned it down and the idea was canned, but can you imagine the outrage that would have went down had Vince forced it upon him?
Oh, wasn't that something? Don't forget to like, share and subscribe below, and also the people who made this lovely video, they're appearing right here. But if you're thinking to yourself, I want to see more content, Jules, then why not look above my head, as there probably is some. I don't know. I can't see it. Until next time.